Hello students, myself Seema Saxena, your biology teacher. Today we are going to discuss some topics of chapter 7 circulatory system of class 8 biology. And the topics which we are going to discuss in this session are agglutination, blood vessels, difference between artery and vein. So first of all, we are coming to our first topic, agglutination. But before discussing this, you should know what are antigens and antibodies. Antigens are the proteins present on the surface of RBCs, while antibodies are present in the blood plasma. Both antigens and antibodies work against each other. Agglutination is the clumping of RBC. When particulate antigens react with specific antibody, antigen-antibody complex forms visible clumping under optimum temperature and pressure. Such a reaction is called agglutination. Antibodies that produce such reactions are called agglutinins. So just one example, see in this diagram, you can see one example they have given. Blood plasma of blood group A contains antibody called anti-B agglutinin. This antibody attacks group B antigens. Antibody B agglutinins link with group B antigens. Thus, if blood group B is injected into a person with blood group A, red blood cells will clump together. This process is called agglutination. So you can see in this diagram very clearly. Then one more thing. People with blood group AB can receive any blood group because of the absence of clumping. For this reason, a person with blood group AB is called a universal recipient. Then a person with blood group O is called a universal donor because his red blood cells have no antigens. Now we are coming on to our second topic, blood vessels. What are blood vessels? Blood vessels are the transport network of our body system. A vessel is defined as a hollow tube that carries blood around the body. In human body, these work as a system of channels through which the blood can flow. The system comprises three types of blood vessels: arteries, veins, and capillaries. So first we are going to discuss about the arteries. So arteries, number one, it carries blood away from the heart towards any organ. All arteries except pulmonary artery carry oxygenated blood. Pulmonary artery is the only artery which carry deoxygenated blood. So children, this is an exception. Please do remember, pulmonary artery is the only artery which carry deoxygenated blood from the heart to the lungs. The walls of artery are made up of three layers. As you are seeing in the diagram, it is tunica externa, tunica media, and tunica interna. Tunica externa, the outermost layer consists of elastic tissues. Tunica media is made up of muscles. And tunica interna is made up of single layered endothelium. Then arteries have a narrow lumen, and the major arteries diverge into minor arteries and then into smaller vessels called arterioles. Arteries are deeply situated in the body and the blood flow in them in spurts. Arteries do not possess any valve because the blood flow in them is unidirectional. After that, we are coming onto the veins. What are veins? Veins are the blood vessels that carry deoxygenated blood from the various body parts to the heart. Only the pulmonary vein carry the oxygenated blood from the lungs to the heart. This is an exception. The veins begin at the capillaries. At first, they are very tiny and are called venules. Small veins join to form the larger ones. The wall of a vein also has three layers as an artery, but they are thinner, less muscular, and less elastic as compared to arterial wall. Then in case of veins, the lumen is much wider. I told you in the arteries, the lumen is narrower, but in case of veins, it is wider. This helps to keep the blood moving easily through the veins. Then in the arteries, I told you that they do not possess any wall, but in case of veins, they are having at regular intervals, the veins have pocket-shaped semilunar walls that open towards the heart to stop the blood flowing in backward direction. So this is the function of the valve, that it stops the blood flowing in the backward direction. The semilunar walls are made up of folds of inner walls of the veins. The forward pressure of blood forces the valves to open, as a result of which blood flows towards the heart. The backflow of blood causes the valve to close. In this diagram also you can see that in first diagram you are able to see it is an open wall of a vein showing the flow of blood, and in the second diagram you are finding a closed wall of a vein prevents the backflow of blood. Then now we are coming onto the capillaries. Capillaries carry blood from arteries to arterioles and from veins to venules. They carry both oxygenated as well as the deoxygenated blood. They have only one cell thick walls, and the walls are absent in capillaries. Now, our next topic is, what are the differences between arteries and veins? Number one, arteries are located deep beneath the skin and veins are located close to the skin. Arteries carry oxygenated blood away from the heart to various body parts except pulmonary artery, which carry deoxygenated blood from the heart to the lungs. In the veins, they bring deoxygenated blood from various body parts into the heart. Only pulmonary vein carry oxygenated blood from lungs to the heart. In arteries, they have three-layered thick muscular wall. But in veins, they have thin, less elastic, and less muscular wall. In arteries, they have a narrow lumen in which the blood flows with high speed and under high pressure. But in veins, they have a wide lumen in which the blood flows with low speed and low pressure. Arteries do not have any valve, but veins have valve which control the unidirectional flow of blood. In this, you have to make the diagram of artery and vein also. So you will, first you will make the diagram and then you will learn all the differences. So thank you, children. Have a nice day.